Thank you, Tamara. Many's the time I've been mistaken, and many times confused. Yes, and I've often felt forsaken, and certainly misused. Ah, but I'm alright, I'm alright, just weary to my bones. Still, you don't expect to be bright and bon vivant so far away from home. So far away from home. I don't know a soul that's not been battered. I don't have a friend who feels at ease. I don't know a dream that's not been shattered or driven to its knees. Ah, but it's all right. It's all right, for we live so well, so long. Still, when I think of the road we're traveling on, I wonder what's gone wrong. Can't help it, I wonder what's going wrong. And I dreamed I was dying. I dreamed that my soul rose unexpectedly, looking back down at me, smiling assuredly. And I dreamed I was flying high up above. My eyes could clearly see the Statue of Liberty sailing away to sea. And I dreamed I was flying. Well, they come on a ship they call the Mayflower. They come on a ship that sailed the moon. They come in the age's most uncertain hours and sing an American tune. Oh, but it's all right. It's all right, it's all right. We can be forever. Still, tomorrow's gonna be another working day, and I'm trying to get some rest. That's all I'm trying, to get some rest. Thank you. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to American Tune. My name's Tom Glenn. It's nice to be here. We came up from Nashville. I think you make the smart choice coming to the 7 p.m. show. You know, the 9 p.m. show, I'll be calling them an Uber. It's going to get ugly. There's no question about it. This show began really as a passion project. These were the artists that I loved as a kid. I was a child of the 70s. And I became a singer-songwriter because of these artists. I like to say I'm a lot like them, minus those pesky hits. But as much as I love the album versions of these songs, there was something about seeing the artist just alone with his guitar performing the songs that really brought it home to me. Just bringing it back to the essence of the song. That's really what this show is about. That first song, American Tune, Paul Simon wrote the lyrics to that because he was bummed out that McGovern lost to Nixon. So luckily our political differences are all behind us now, so we can move on. The music to that was actually written by Johann Sebastian Bach, of Bach and Garfunkel fame, but Paul took that music and put it to his own lyric. This next song was Jim Croce's first number one song, And Jim was in the Army, stationed at Fort Jackson, South Carolina. And there was one payphone there for all the soldiers, and a big long line at all times. And usually when they would call home, it was good news and talking to loved ones, but sometimes it was to confirm that that Dear John letter they got in the mail was the real thing. So this song came of that. And if you know the chorus, feel free to sing along.
Could you help me place this call? Seems the number on the matchbook is old and faded. He's living in LA with my ex-old best friend Ray, a guy she said she knew well and sometimes hated. Isn't that the way they say it goes? Let's forget all that and give me the number if you can find it, so I can call just to tell him I'm fine and to show I overcome the blow. I learned to take it well, only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. That's not the way it feels. Operator, could you help me place this call? 'Cause I can't read the number that you just gave me. There's something in my eyes, you know it happens every time. I think about the love that I thought would save me. Isn't that the way they say it goes? Let's forget all that and give me the number if you can find it, so I can call just to tell him I'm fine and to show I've overcome the blow. I learned to take it well, only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. If that's not the way it feels, no, 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 no. That's not the way it feels. Operator, let's forget about this call. There's no one there I really wanted to talk to. Thank you for your time. You've been so much more than kind. You can keep the dime. Isn't that the way they say it goes? Let's forget all that and give me the number if you can find it, so I can call just to tell them I'm fine and to show I've overcome the blow. I learned to take it well, only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels.
Meanwhile, poor James Taylor, we know some of the stories of his early trials and tribulations, but while things were not going too smoothly for him here, he decided to go over to Europe and see what came there, basically loiter over in Europe for a while. And while he was there, some friends convinced him to make a demo tape, which he did. And he got it in the hands of Peter Asher. Does anyone remember the band Peter and Gordon? Okay, yeah. Peter was Peter of Peter and Gordon. Probably gathered that. Anyway, he was the A&R guy at the time for the Beatles and their new label, Apple Records. And James got him a copy of this and he loved it. And he said, how would you feel about coming over here and playing a couple of your songs for the Beatles live in the room? He's like, sure, I got nothing going on. So he went over and Paul McCartney and George Harrison were there and he played him this song and it changed the course of his life. Well, there's something in the way she moves, looks my way and calls my name, that seems to leave this trouble behind. And if I'm feeling down and blue, or troubled by some foolish game, she always seems to make me change my mind. I feel fine any time that she's around me now. She's around me now, almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell that she's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time, and I feel. Every now and then, the things I lean on lose their meaning. I find myself careening places where I should not let me go. She has the power to go, but no one else can find me. And a silent dream reminds me of the happiness and good times that I know. Well, I said I just got to know it. It isn't what she's got to say, or how she thinks or where she's been. To me, the words are nice the way they sound. I like to hear them best that way. It doesn't much matter what they mean. She says them mostly just to calm me. I feel fine any time that she's around me now. She's around me now almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell that she's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time. Yes, and I feel fine. James likes to joke that Paul McCartney loved the song and George liked it so much he went home and wrote it. One of the great things about Paul Simon is how humble he is, and he was on the anyone remember the Dick Cavett show? It was a long time ago. Okay, yeah. But Dick was great because you would have these musicians on and really have a deep discussion about music. And he was not a musician, so it was always very interesting to hear it from sort of the layman and the musician's perspective. And Paul brought a song one time, this half-written song, and he asked Dick if he had any ideas on how to finish it. Dick had no ideas on how to finish the song. Other than asking Paul if he ever reached for his C natural and got his C sharp. So I don't know. Dick jokes. Dick Cavett jokes, sorry. This was one, not surprisingly, that Paul finished on his own.
Met my old lover on the street last night. She's
seemed so glad to see me, I just smiled. We talked about some old times and we drank ourselves some beers. Still crazy after all these years. Oh, still crazy after all these years. I'm not the kind of man who tends to socialize. I seem to lean on old familiar ways. And I ain't no fool for love songs that whisper in my ear. Still crazy after all these years. Oh, still crazy after all these years. Four in the morning, crapped out, yawning, longing my life away. I'll never worry, why should I? It's all gonna fade. Now I sit by my window and I watch the cars. I fear I'll do some damage one fine day. But I would not be convicted by a jury of my peers. Still crazy after all these years. Oh, still crazy. Still crazy. Still crazy after all these years.
This was a song for a long time that I thought Jim Croce had actually written, but it was actually written by Charles Fox and Norman Gimbel, household names. And yeah, they've written some classic songs, Killing Me Softly with her song, with his song rather, Roberta Flack, one of those, take your pick. And other timeless chestnuts like the theme to Happy Days and the theme to Laverne and Shirley. They had been contracted to write a song for a new TV movie called The Last American Hero. And they heard Jim Croce on the radio singing Operator. And they said, well, this guy would be perfect for this. So they called him up, they played him a song. And there's a line in there about a father, a dad, and Jim said that he had to record the song because of that. Jim had a very strained relationship with his father. His father did not want him to become a musician at all, and unfortunately died before Jim had any success, so he never got to see that. Ironically and tragically, this song was released on September 21st, 1973, a day after Jim himself perished.
Like the pine trees lining the running road, I got a name, I got a name. Like the singing bird and the broken toe, I got a name, I got a name. And I carry it with me like my daddy did, but I'm living the dream that he once hid. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Like the pines ring whistling down the sky, I got a song, I got a song. Like the whippoorwill and the babies cry, I got a song, I got a song.
And I carry it with me and I sing it loud. If it gets me nowhere, I'll go there proud. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so that won't pass me by. Like the fool I am, and I'll always be. I got a dream. I got a dream. They can change their minds, but they can't change me. I got a dream. I got a dream. I know I could share it if you want me to. If you're going my way, I'll go with you. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. So that's, does that count? Normally I don't, so this is wonderful. How about this room? How about the velvet now? Huh? It's so great. You two, make yourselves comfortable, whatever you want. Thank you. Well, this next song proves you can have everything going right for you and still be homesick. James Taylor was sharing a studio with the Beatles while they were recording the White Album, and he was recording his first album, and they were taking up time in the studio, so James took a little R&R time on a little island off of Spain, and he met a girl there named Karen. And they could not afford a hotel, so they ended up sleeping on the beach. And well, Karen slept on a little patio there outside a cafe, and James stayed up all night and wrote this song. And he missed his hometown in North Carolina.
In my mind, I'm going to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? And I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Karen, she's a silver sun. You best walk her away and watch her shine. Watch her watch the morning come. Silver tear appearing now, I'm dying, need I? I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. There ain't no doubt in no one's mind that love's the finest thing around. Whisper something soft and kind. Signs of the omen say, I'm going, I'm going, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? And I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. With a holy host of others standing around me. Still I'm on the dark side of the moon, and it seems like it goes on like this forever. You must forgive me if I'm up and gone to Carolina in my mind. In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? And can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? And I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Say nice things about me, I'm gone. Carry on without me, I'm gone. Gone to Carolina in my mind. And I'm gone to Carolina.
In case you missed it, that's my exercise for the evening. Trying to get some cardio in. When Paul Simon first wrote this song, it was called "Going Home," and Paul was thinking, "Going home, I can't write a song called Going Home. What's that? Going home, going home. Oh, Kodachrome, yeah." Some of you maybe old enough to remember this. There was an AM version and an FM version of this. It seems that curse words are the theme here tonight. This next song had the word crap in the FM version, which was, you know, very exciting as a youngster. That seemed like a real win. Although I should mention I had a full headgear, so the bar was set very, very low. When I think back on all the crap I learned in high school, it's a wonder I can think at all. And my lack of education hasn't hurt me none. I can read the writing on the wall. Kodachrome, give us this nice bright colors. Give us those greens of summers. Makes you think all the world's in a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got an Nikon camera. I love to take a photograph. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome away. If you took all the girls I knew when I was single, brought them all together for one night, I know they never match my sweet imagination. And everything looks worse in black and white. Kodachrome, give us those nice bright colors. Give us those greens of summers. Makes you think all the world's in a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got a Nikon camera to take a photograph. Mama gonna take my phone home away.
Mama gonna take my Kodachrome away. Mama gonna take my Kodachrome away. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama don't take my Kodachrome. Mama don't take my Kodachrome. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama don't take my Kodachrome. Leave your boy so far from home. Mama don't take my Kodachrome away.
I think somewhere in that song I started singing "Going Home," but I'm making up my own words again. During Jim Croce's early career, he really struggled to make it for many, many years before anyone had ever heard of him. And in the midst of struggling, he came home one night and Ingrid was standing there and she said, Jim, I'm pregnant. And she said he looked at her with a look of, at the same time, sheer joy and sheer horror. Later on that night, he sat down at the kitchen table and he wrote this song.
Save time in a bottle. The first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do, won't you, Father? I looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go through time with. Just for wishes and dreams that had never come true, the box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you. But there never seemed to be enough time to do the things you want to do, won't you, Fonda? I looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go through time with.
If you get a chance, Ingrid Croce, Jim's wife, wrote a great book, a biography of Jim. It's hard to put down, and it's a lot of stories in there are very, very surprising. I won't blow it for you, but it's quite a shock, some things. But what was I going to say? Oh, yeah. So one show in Philadelphia where he lived, James Taylor was sharing a bill with him. James was already a big star at this point, and Jim was not. Nobody knew who Jim was, but they played a bill together with some other people, And they all went back to Jim's house after, and they partied and hung out and stayed over and all that. And Ingrid explained to James that she had been serenading their newborn baby AJ to bed every night, singing a song of his. And that night in her living room, she got to hear it live from James himself.
There is a young cowboy, he lives on the range. His horse and his cattle are his only companions. He works in the saddle and sleeps in the canyons, waiting for summer, his pastures to change. And as the moon rises, he sits by his fire, thinking about women and glasses of beer, closing his eyes as the doggies retire, sings out a song which is soft but clear, as if maybe someone could hear. Saying goodnight, all you moonlight ladies, rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Greens and blues for the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down in my dreams and rock a bye, sweet baby James. Now the 1st of December was covered with snow. So was the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston. Though the Berkshire seemed dreamlike on account of that frosting, the 10 miles behind me, 10,000 more to go, you know. There's a song that they sing when they take to the highway, a song that they sing when they take to the sea, a song that they sing of their home in the sky. Maybe you can believe it if it helps you to sleep. Singing seemed to work fine for me. So good night, all you moonlight ladies, rock 'em by, sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down in my dreams? Oh, rockin' by us, baby James.
I'm winded.
Problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you with your struggle to be free. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. She said it's really not my habit to intrude. Furthermore, I hope my meaning won't be lost or misconstrued. But I'll repeat myself at the risk of being crude. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan to stand. don't need to be coy, Roy. Just get yourself free. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, Lee, and get yourself free. She said, I grieved and so to see you in such pain. I wish there was something I could do to make you smile again. I said, I appreciate that. Would you please explain about the 50 ways? She said, why don't we both just sleep on it tonight? And I believe that in the morning you'll begin to see the light. And then she kissed me, and I realized she probably was right. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. You just slip out the back, Jack. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just listen to me. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, leave, and get yourself free. Hop on the bus, Gus. Make a new plan, Stan. You don't need to be coy, Roy. Just listen to me. Hop on the bus, Gus. You don't need to discuss much. Just drop off the key, leave, and get yourself free.
Thanks so much. Of course, you can tell I read the Ingrid Croce book because I won't shut up about Jim Croce stories. So here's another one. this was a story that was pretty typical of what went on with the two of them once Jim finally made it. What happens to a lot of artists, obviously, is their life changes so dramatically that their home life becomes a bit strained. And Ingrid was home the entire time that Jim was out on the road, tending to their baby, AJ. And when he did come home, it was kind of tough. On this particular night, they ended up having a big fight, and Jim had just got off the road, and they got a big fight, and she went up to her room, and Jim sat down and went down to the living room and woke her up in the middle of the night and said, Ing, you gotta hear this. And she said, oh, leave me alone. And he said, no, you really gotta hear this. And he had written this while she was sleeping.
I know it's kind of late. I hope I didn't wake you. There's something that I just gotta say. I know you'd understand. And every time I tried to tell you, the words just came out wrong. So I have to say I love you in a song. Yeah, I know it's kind of strange. But every time I'm near you, I just run out of things to say. I know you'd understand. And every time I tried to tell you, the words just came out wrong. So I have to say I love you in a song. Every time the time was right, all the words just came wrong. So I have to say I love you in a song. Yeah, I know it's kinda late. I hope I didn't wake you. But there's something that I just gotta say. I know you'd understand. And every time I tried to tell you, the words just came out wrong. So I have to say I love you in a song.
Well, I guess if we had to sum up the singer-songwriter movement of the 70s in one song, it would probably have to be this one.
Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans are made for the next. Walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. You just gotta see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. And I can't make it any other way. And I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time. My back turns towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Spend hours of time on the telephone line, talking about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines and pieces on the ground. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you, baby, one more time again. Thought I'd see you one more time again. There's just a few things coming my way this time around. Thought I'd see you, thought I'd see you, fire and rain.
Well, I called the show American Tune, but we'd be remiss if we didn't do a quick one-song shout-out to Canada's greatest singer-songwriter. Canada gets very touchy about that. Bob Dylan once said of Gordon Lightfoot that when he hears one of Gordon's songs come on, he never wants it to end. And of course, he almost got his wish with the record, The End, and Edmund Fitzgerald, but that's a long song. But this is one of my favorite songs of all time. I think it's one of the most beautiful songs ever written.
You could read my mind, love, what a tale of thoughts could tell. Just like an old time movie about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark or a fortress strong, chains above my feet, you know that ghost is me. And I will never be set free as long as I'm a ghost that you can't see. If I could read your mind, love, what a tale your thoughts would tell. Just like a paperback novel, the kind the drugstore would sell. When you reach the part where the heartaches come, the hero would be me, but heroes often fail. And you won't read that book again, because the ending's just too hard to take. I'll walk away like a movie star who gets burned in a three-way script. Enter number two. A movie queen to play the scene by bringing all the good things out in me. But for now, love, let's be real. Never thought I could act this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone. I just can't get it back. If you could read my love, what a tale my thoughts would tell. Just like an old time movie about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet. But stories always end, and if you read between the lines, you'll know that I'm just trying to understand the feelings that you lack. Never thought I could feel this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, the feeling's gone, and I just can't get it back.
Have I written anything? Oh, I've written. Sure, one of my own?
Sure.
If you don't mind. Thank you, sir. This actually has a bit of a tie-in. Anyone familiar with Livingston Taylor? Livingston was James's brother, and he's a tremendous artist in his own right. And some years back, he also became the head of A&R at a label city starting up in Boston. I'm originally from Boston, and Livingston wanted to sign me as their first artist. He was a fan of my songwriting, and I had a band at that time called Big Dig in Boston. Yep. They named them. Yeah.
Could you enunciate, please?
What was the name of the band?
Oh, Big Digga.
Gotcha.
Thank you for clarifying. Now I know you like steamrollers so much. Anyway, it was going to be a great situation. We showcased for him. It was all set to go. And, you know, one quick side note, Livingston brought me out to lunch as a way to kind of make the signing happen. And in the middle of it, he says, Tom, I'm worried about James. And I'm sitting there, the biggest James fan in the world, you know. And he said, you know, he'd rather live in a hotel room than a house. And I think that was pretty much James's life for a long time until recent years when he's become a bit of a homebody, I believe. Anyway, the label never got off the ground because the guy who owned it, Don Loss, sold his whole company to Clear Channel at the very last minute. So unfortunately, we never got that opportunity, but this was a song that Livingston really liked, and it actually went on to win the John Lennon Songwriting Contest the first year they had it.
Look at all this time and still you're always on my mind. Skylight invention, a creation by design. Do you think that I would leave you swinging in the breeze? You don't know me. Magic bunny wonder reaching for a tambourine. I'll record you here on paper, and I'll store you in my dreams. And my world is getting smaller, nothing's as it seems, you've shown me. And when our time has come, if you're still around, we'll go down to the water. Picture in this time since you were born. And if we drown, it's no wonder. Then I'll find a place to keep you warm. And every time I've seen the purple mountains to the canyon I will run. I want to see you at the altar. I want to feel you when you come. It's the long anticipation and this agonizing need for you to know me. Magic body wonder reaching for a tambourine. If you stay here any longer, you will bring me to my knees. And my world is getting smaller, and nothing's as it seems, you've shown me. And when our time has come, if you're still around, we'll go down to the water. Picture in this time since you were born. And if we drown, it's no wonder. Then I'll find a place to keep you warm.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thanks so much. You can actually find my CD on all streaming platforms. The CD is called Skylight Intervention, and that song is on it. And I believe this song I did not write is also on it. There's two covers on that on the record, along with all the originals. One of them is Operator, and the other is this song, which is one of my all-time favorites. And James did a great cover of this song. I'm gonna roll from one of the great things about James is that he's not only a great songwriter, but he does amazing cover songs. So I'm gonna roll from one of his covers that I love right into one of his originals. And you can find this version of it on my CD, written by the great Jimmy Webb. made famous by Glen Campbell.
I am a lineman for the county, and I drive the main road, searching in the sun for another load. I hear you singing in the wire, I can hear you through the wine, and the Wichita lineman is still on the line. No, I need a small vacation, but it don't look like rain. And if it snows, that stretch down south won't ever stand straight. And I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time. And the Wichita lineman is still on the line. And I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time. And the Wichita lineman is still on the line. Take to the highway, won't you lend me your name? Your way and my way seem to be one and the same. Mama don't understand it, you got to know where I've been. I have to be some kind of natural born fool to want to pass that away again. But you know I could feel it. On a country road, sail on home to Jesus, won't you, good girls and boys? I'm all in pieces, you can have your own choice. But I can hear a heavenly band full of angels are coming just to set me free. Oh, I don't know nothing about why or when, but I can tell you that it's bound. I could feel it on a country road. I reckon my feet know where they want me to go. Walking down a country road. Walk on down, walk on down, walk on down, walk on down, walking down a country road. La 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 la. Country road. Walking down a country road.
See Paul Simon on Stephen Colbert the other week. He's
82 now.
Stephen Colbert? No. Yeah, he looks good. Oh, Paul, yeah. Paul, yeah. It was a great interview. It was like a half hour interview with Paul. And I know what's going on. I forgot to retune after this. Anyway, Stephen told a really touching story in the middle of it. He was in his car. When he was a kid, he was in the car with his mom, and Slip, Slide, and Away came on. And she was sitting there in the car, and that line came on about a good day ain't got no rain, and a bad day is when I lie in bed and think of things that might have been. And his mom went, oh. She said, that's so true. And Stephen said he realized a couple things about his mom on that day. This is one of my favorite all-time songs by him. Sing along if you know it.
Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know the need just a nation, the more you slip sliding away. I know a man, he came from my hometown. He wore his passion for his woman like a thorny crown. He said, Dolores, I live in fear. My love for you is so overpowering, I'm afraid that I will disappear. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the near your destination, the more you slip sliding away. And I know a woman became a wife. These are the very words she uses to describe a life. She said, a good day ain't got no rain. She said, a bad day's when I lie in bed and think of things that might have been. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the near your destination, the more you slip sliding away. Now I know a father and a son. He longed to tell him all the reasons for the things he'd done. He came a long way just to explain. He kissed his boy as he lay sleeping, then he turned around and headed home again. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the near destination, the more you slip sliding away. God only knows, God makes his plans. The information's unavailable to the mortal man. We're working our jobs, collect our pay. Believe we're gliding down the highway when in fact we're slip sliding away. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the near your destination, the more you slip sliding away. Mm-hmm. I want to know.
Thank you, folks. Well, I just want to thank you guys all for coming down tonight. This is the first time ever playing at the Velvet Note, and you really made it wonderful. Thank you. Thank you to Tamara. Thank you to JB. Thank you to the staff. This was this was Jim Croce's last number one hit. And it's the last song he ever performed live, about an hour before his untimely death in the plane crash on September 20th, 1973. But he wrote it about a sergeant that he was in the Army with who really thought he was something. And the only problem was he wasn't the brightest guy in the world. He went AWOL, and then he got caught when he came back for his check 2 weeks later. His name was Leroy Brown. Sing along if you can and help me with the rhythm.
On the south side of Chicago, in the baddest part of town. And if you go down there, you better just beware of a man named Leroy Brown. Well, Leroy, only trouble, you see, he's standing about 6'4". All the downtown ladies call him Treetop Lover. All the men just call him Sir. And he's bad, bad Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong. And meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, Leroy, he a gambler, and he liked his fancy clothes, and he liked to wear his diamond ring in front of everybody's nose. He got a custom Continental, he got an Eldorado too. He got a 32 gun in his pocket for fun. He got a razor in his shoe. And he's bad, bad Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong. And meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, Friday, about a week ago, Leroy shooting dice. And at the edge of the bar sat a girl named Doris. And ooh, that girl looked nice. Well, he cast his eyes upon her, and the trouble soon began. Leroy Brown had learned a lesson by messing with the wife of a jealous man. And he's bad, bad Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong. And meaner than a junkyard dog. Well, the two men took to fighting. And when they rolled him on the floor, Leroy looked like a jigsaw puzzle with a couple of pieces gone. And he's bad.
Bad Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong.
And meaner than a junkyard dog. Yeah, he's bad. Bad Leroy Brown. Baddest man in the whole damn town. Badder than old King Kong. And meaner than a junkyard dog. Yeah, he was badder than old King Kong. And meaner than a junkyard dog.
Thank you so much, everyone. Have a wonderful night.
That's American Tune by Tom Glenn. Give it up. Now, yes, yes, yes.
Cancel it. Cancel it. Cancel it. I heard someone whisper, "Encore."
Yes!
Absolutely.
Here in the great state of Georgia, we have many sports teams. We have a lot of muscle memory when it comes to shouting out, "Encore."
Well, since that sing-along went so well, here's another one you might know. James Taylor said of this next song that the two greatest things to ever happen to him in his life were this song and meeting his wife. And then he was quick to reverse the order. Written by the great Carole King. When you're down and troubled and you need a helping hand, and nothing, well, nothing is going right, close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes, I'm there. You've got a friend. If the sky high above you should turn dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind should begin to blow, keep your poor head together now and call my name out loud. Soon I'll be knocking on your door. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes, I'll be there. Hey, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend? People can be so cold. They'll hurt you and desert you. They'll take your soul if you let them. But don't you let them. You just call. Good to know that you've got a friend.
good to know you've got a friend. Oh yeah, yeah, you've got a friend.
An abbreviated version of something, so we don't hold anybody up there. I don't want to see fisticuffs outside.
I have officially lost control. You better make this really, really good. There are people peeking in the window. Enjoy.
My story's seldom told. I have squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies in jest, till the man hears what he wants to hear, disregards the rest. When I left my home and my family, it's no more than a boy in the company of strangers, quiet of the railway station, running scared, laying low, seeking out the poorer quarters where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know. La la la, la 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 la. La 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 la. In the clearing stands a boxer and a fighter by his trade, and he carries the reminders of every glove that's made him cut him till he cried out in his anger and his shame. I am leaving, I am leaving, but the finest still remains. La 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 la. La 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 la.
Thank you, folks, so much. We really appreciate it. Have a wonderful night.
There's no encore now. I just want to say that there are a few of you who have never been here before, and you've been waiting for a night when there's no jazz, and you'll never be here again.
Oh, your whole town's coming back.
I know. I'll let you know when he comes back. This is what we love to do, which is to bring you closer to artists who inspire you, closer to each other, and closer to the song that's in your heart. On behalf of JB and Sheila and Makai and Justin, good night.